From Memphis, Tennessee, TPC Southwind for the final day of the FedEx St. Jude Classic. They had to finish up the third round early Sunday morning. With all that bad weather pushing back the schedule, they finally were able to get back and down to the final round. Phil Mickelson, this was in the third round early in the day. Off the green at 13, a nice hole out for Mickelson. He would have an up and down final round, which would lead to a T11 finish. Camila Villegas looking for birdie at the fourth, downhill putt, and Villegas putting a solid 4 days together, including three rounds in the 60s. Billy Horschel tacking the 10th. Horschel with a 68 in the third round, which he finished on Sunday morning. Nearly a hole out there. Ian Poulter, downhill putt at the 18th. And Poulter trying to climb into the top five. He would finish T6 up 29 spots in the final round. Matt Every, also a good week. The winner at Bay Hill Club and Lodge with a long putt hold at the 18th. Every would climb a spot into the top three at week's end. Webb Simpson working the 16th. This one of just two par fives on the course. And that settles just past the flag. That would lead to birdie. Webb Simpson would get to 8 under par. He'll be looking forward to Pinehurst next week, possibly a second U.S. Open. Troy Merritt, very few cuts made. Didn't play a PGA Tour event in 2012 or 13, yet he comes into Memphis. He was on fire, solid all week. The birdie on the front side, and then this for par at 18. It circles the cup, and he would be in at 9 under. Would it be enough? Well, Ben Crane started the day at 13 under, was struggling a bit, but he saves par at 13 after two bogeys on the front side. What a save there. And then at 15, playing to a downhill pin. Plenty of touch from Crane. And he would go through the entire final round without a birdie on the card, a bogey, in fact, at the last. But he wins by a shot, his first since the 2011 McGlathry, and the fifth career win for Crane. We move on to the U.S. Open. You can enjoy coverage Thursday beginning at 9 a.m. on ESPN, followed by NBC at 3 p.m. Eastern.